Hello everyone. The most expected TCS National Qualifier Test for the batch 2020 is here. So let's discuss the important instructions and the points to be noted for coding round. Let's get started. Here you go. So there is only one question that you have to code for this TCS National Qualifier Test, and you will be provided with 30 minutes. And you can code in either C language or C++, Java, Perl or Python 2.7. So out of these 5 programming languages, you can choose any one. You will be provided with an IDE for each and every language where you can type your code and debug. Let me explain what is an IDE. For example, in online we have something called as Java Doodle or J Doodle. You have another compiler called as GDB Online Debugger. So these are the two famous compilers that we generally use for programming practices. Similar to this IDE, you will have something called as TCS specific IDE in your interview itself, where you can code and you can compile and check what are all the errors that you can get. If your choice of language is Java, then your class name should be always Maze. That is, for example, in JDoodle, if this is the IDE that I am going to use, then by default this IDE has defined me something called as my class as the class name. But in TCS, since you have to code from the scratch, we have to start from public static void main. Everything we have to code from first. So name your class name as Maze. Input to the program should be either through standard input or command line arguments as per the instructions. So there are chances where you might get questions from command line arguments. It's very highly unlikely, because in the last year we didn't receive any coding question with command line. We just used scanf itself. But still we have to know what is a command line, because it will be helpful for us to crack 2 to 3 MCQs from command line arguments. Program should be written to the output area, and public and private test cases based evaluation will happen. Here, assume this is your TCS platform. So here we have 2 test cases for the given question, circumference of a circle. So these 2 test cases are said to be visible test cases, because you can see whether the test cases are passed or not, isn't it? So here it says the test case didn't pass, but this test case is passed. First test case is passed and second test case is not passed. So these are all visible test cases where you can see the status of the test case. But the questioner may include hidden test cases as well, but the test cases will not be visible in our screen. So in order to clear this coding round, it is mandatory for you to clear both the visible test case and the hidden test case for a particular program. While printing the output, there are certain points that we have to consider. First one is, while printing the output, no leading or trailing spaces should be printed. Let's go to the same example, same question. Here, the output consists of only numbers, that too without any spaces before or after. If I try to give spaces or lines, any line spaces before, then what happens is the output will be the same, 78.50, here also 78.50, but the spacings are different. So the compiler will not pass the output is same, but the spacings are different. Therefore, the compiler will not pass this test case. Other than the required output, no other text should be printed. Here, the output requires only the circumference and no other texts. So, if I try to print it as, circum is equal to, the answer is same as 78.50. Here also it's 78.50. But the problem is, in the expected output you have only numbers, but in our output you have texts as well. So this will all again make the compiler fail the test case. So whatever output is expected, same output has to be replicated there. We cannot include any texts inside the printf statements unless it's asked. If the output is a number, no leading sign must be printed unless it's a negative number. So only for a negative number we will be printing the minus sign. For all the positive numbers there is no need to print plus in the output. No scientific notations should be used. All floating point numbers must contain that many decimal places as mentioned in the question. Let me go back to the same question. Here the question clearly says that your output should contain 2-point precision. So if I try to make it as 1-point precision over here, check the error. Here the expected output is 153.86, but my output is 153.9. Therefore the test cases didn't pass. So if I make it as 2-point precision, you will get the correct output. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to receive notifications of our videos. All the best guys.